Hello everyone, welcome. I was led to tell you how God showed me how to pray and what to pray for. So, before I start, let us first thank our Father for this blessing of bringing us together here tonight. Our Almighty Father in heaven and here on earth, we give you all praise and glory for this opportunity to find encouragement in our stand. May you open the hearts of everyone listening that they may find light in your words and message. Please let the Holy Spirit speak through the words that come out of my mouth and not my own. In Jesus' name, we ask. Amen. Okay, so I hope everyone is having a good day today. It's evening here now, and it's raining outside. Thank you, God, for the blessing of rain. It's been very, very hot lately. So, everyone, we have all been through the time in our life when our knowledge of praying to God is, you know, mostly thanking Him for the blessings that He continuously gives us. Most of the time, it's asking, you know, asking for the things that we need, you know, for the things that we want. Sometimes when we're going through struggles in life, we ask Him why, right? Or sometimes we plead to Him to get, you know, to remove struggles in our life. You know, this is okay, but this is just scratching the surface. You have to know, guys, that there is no right and wrong prayer or way of praying, but these types of prayers are mostly scratching the surface. You know, when we're standing for our marriages, we have to seek God. Seek Him with all of our hearts. If we truly want to experience His infinite glory in our lives, we have to know who He is. Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 tells us, "But seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you." When my husband left and I knew that nothing I did would ever get him to come back home, my whole world stood still. There was nothing I could do about it. In the flesh, I knew I couldn't do anything. But I knew that God was there for me. And you know what? I sought God. And so He sent godly people my way. Okay, so one time, a friend visited me. This friend just came from a trip. She dropped by our home to drop off her gifts for me and the children. And so as we were talking, you know, nothing was mentioned of anything about, you know, what happened, because she was out of the country and she didn't know anything. Then just all of a sudden, she just started telling me her story. I had an idea, but I never asked. Because, you know, I value people's privacy, and I also don't want people to ask me about, you know, things in my life. So I never asked her before, but she suddenly just told me her story. She told me how she found God and how now she walks with Jesus. And as she's walking with Jesus, she said she was carrying her cross beside Him. And in this walk, she has found happiness. Happiness with Jesus carrying her cross. So I was so amazed with her story. It seemed so hard and unbelievable that she surrendered all control to God, and she truly believes that He will get her through it all. So in my amazement, I asked her if she truly believed in her heart that God will send her husband back home and He will restore their marriage. She looked at me and she smiled and answered, "Yes, I believe in my heart that God will restore my marriage." She was at that time standing for 5 years. Her husband left her 5 years. So a month later, she messaged me. And she told me that her husband sent her a message that he was coming home. After 5 years, he was coming home. Glory be to God. To God all be the glory. So anyway, this friend of mine was the first one who explained to me and made me realize why I was where I was. She said, "You know, I saw how close your family was, how tight-knit you all were." She clenched her fist and said, "This is how your family looked like." She showed me her fist. The problem was, Jesus was not a part of it. He had to break the closeness. Then she opened her fist, showed it to me again, and said, "Now he can get through." So remember, ladies, God is a jealous God. So is your husband the center of your life? Your family? Are you prioritizing your husband that you've forgotten about God? Remember, a partnership, a marriage, a family without God at the center is weak. It is bound to fail. Ecclesiastes 4, verse 12. "Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken." Having God at the center of your marriage, having God between you and your husband, makes your union a three-cord strand. Marriage is God's design, and He is for us. We know how many times it says in the Bible that God hates divorce. Have you been grateful to God for gifting you your marriage? Does your marriage glorify God? You know, by not having God at the center of your union, you opened yourselves to the attacks of the enemy. The devil has his eyes on destroying families because families are the foundation of our society. He breaks up families, our society crumbles. Our society is what makes up our church, the church of God. Now, going back to God being a jealous God, He is our creator. Everything we are and everything we have is from Him. And He is a God who loves us and is abundant in His blessings. But what do? We forget this. We neglect Him. We go about our lives with the excuse that we're just too busy, or we forgot. Or worse, we make ourselves believe that we can do it on our own. Matthew chapter 6, verse 24 says, "No one can serve two masters, for he will hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to the one and despise the other." You cannot serve God and money. So I pondered on this for days, prayed how I knew how to pray, and asked the Lord for forgiveness. I went to see a priest and wholeheartedly confessed my sins to the Lord. I also asked God to teach me how to pray more effectively, how He wanted me to pray. I researched for prayers for my marriage to be restored and read those prayers every day. I felt I was on the right path, but I still felt I could do more. I wanted to know more. I needed to do more. I wanted to seek God. So I prayed harder and asked the Lord to teach me. He led me to listen to YouTube. And as I have mentioned in my earlier videos, that I have never opened YouTube before. I searched and listened and watched videos about marriage restoration, about how to pray, how to seek God. I took notes, I copied prayers, and put my husband's name on all of them. I added on my prayer time. I still felt I needed more. The more I prayed and the more I sought God, I physically and spiritually felt the thirst to know more and to have more. My prayers at the time wasn't enough to quench the thirst I felt. So, I started reading the Bible. I breathed in His Word. I took down notes. I highlighted scriptures, scriptures that spoke to me. I highlighted my favorite color pink, blue for anything about God and Jesus, yellow for scriptures about sin, and orange for special messages. I would draw hearts on those that hit me the most. I wrote on my journal and memorized scriptures. I have good days, bad days, and worse days, but I pushed forward. I plow my way through my days, confident that I have God as my shield against all the harsh realities of life. I make it through one day at a time with Jesus beside me. I made plans. But all these plans, when I brought to God, He would always say, "Be still." I would always hear the Holy Spirit inside of me tell me, "Be still, I am working on your problem." The Holy Spirit kept on telling me, "Trust in God's plan," for me to just be still. At first, I would even argue with God that it was hard for me not to worry. Because, you know, in as much as I trust Him, I was also a mother. Oh boy, what was I thinking? Did I really think God did not know that? Of course He knows. He is God. He knows everything. You know, He knows even before we ask. But I still wanted to have control. I was so scared. But no matter what I did, no matter what I tried, find a job, invest in a business, nothing came through. The voice in me still insisted that I be still. He showed me in the Bible in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6. "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him and He will direct your paths." So, finally, I did exactly that. I knew that there was so much work needed in me, and I needed to do it first. God wanted me to be in prayer. He wanted me to dedicate myself wholly to Him at that time. This was back in January of this year. I got down on my knees and cried to God and surrendered everything to Him. I asked Him, "Please do whatever you want to do with me and with my life. I am laying it down at the foot of the cross of Jesus." And every day now, I go to God. I pray and offer to Him everything. I praise, I worship, and I thank the Lord God Almighty. You know what? My life has been one blessing after another. One miracle after another. God has even sent me angels in my times of need. Incredible. Amazing. You know, there are still bad days. The devil is working harder. The closer you are to God, the harder the devil will work to make sure that you give up on God. But it has just been one victory after another. God continues to amaze me every day. He truly is a God who keeps His promises. So before God restores your marriage, He will restore you first. He will restore your relationship with Him. He is also working to restore your husband on the other side. So people of God, know that God is working for you. God loves you. He loves your husband. And He wants your marriage restored. But it is to be in a perfect place, both of you. So people of God, I hope this has encouraged you to continue standing and believing that you will come out of this a perfect creation of God. So I hope that this has encouraged you, And I hope that this has blessed you today as you have blessed me. Thank you for listening, and I will be back soon. God bless. Bye-bye. So, thank you again for taking time out to listen to this video, and I hope that this has encouraged you all. Please don't forget to hit subscribe and like this video so that we can be together again soon. Also, don't forget to hit the notification bell too. See ya.